Auditions are underway for the new season of American Idol. Thousands of Americans will try out, but only a few will become finalists on the show. As our next guest can tell you, singing on Idol is a tough gig, and he should know. He was a top 10 finalist from season 6.
Pain and tribulations.
Chris Sligh, a worship leader from South Carolina, was a standout last year on American Idol. But he'll tell you what really led to his success.
I went into American Idol and very early on was a favorite, and then I went home 10th. And I was going, God, what are you doing through this? Like, I mean, I went home way earlier than what I was planning on and what I was hoping for. And then all of a sudden, I end up getting a record deal that is beyond my belief. It's like going, okay, God, I get it. You know, you're in control.
Chris says he felt God pushing him out of mainstream media and into Christian music. He signed with Brash Records after passing up a secular record label with a $250,000 contract.
It took a long time and a lot of prayer to walk away from that much money.
Chris grew up in a Christian home, but admits he got into the music biz for the fame and fortune. But as he learned to surrender to the Lord, he realized that he had a greater call.
With me. Am I everything you want for me to be?
Please welcome to the 700 Club American Idol finalist, Chris Sligh. Chris, great to have you with
us. So good to be here.
Program today. The last line of that story talked about a greater call that you felt in your life. Tell me about that. What is it?
As a believer, I think that there is a call for us to definitely do what you guys are doing, where you guys are Christians in mainstream media, and obviously this is a Christian show, and I think that's an important thing. But for some reason, I felt like God was calling me to do something for the church and to make music for the church specifically. And it was one of those decisions that was a tough decision to come to, because after being on American Idol, you know, you're in front of 40 million people there. You know, I was on the cover of People magazine twice.
Kind of what's your appetite for?
Yeah. And so it was kind of coming to that place of going, God, obviously you're opening up all these doors for me to go into mainstream media as a Christian, right? And then for him to come back and go, man, I really think you're supposed to do something for the church. And so it came back, and, you know, it's an exciting time to be able to make music for the church and my brothers and sisters and for my family. Mm-hmm. Basically coming back to the family is, it's a great feeling.
You had an interesting experience in college. You were actually expelled from college. But you say that that was maybe the best thing that could have happened to you. Talk about why that happened and how God used that in your
life.
Well,
you know, I grew up in a conservative Baptist background, and I went to a very conservative college and got kicked out for actually going to a Christian music concert because
that's pretty interesting.
Yeah, because it was rock and roll, and
wow.
And so I getting kicked out definitely opened up the doors for me to kind of seek out who God was. God is so much bigger than I think these boxes that we put them in sometimes. Mm-hmm. As with legalism.
Were you bitter after that?
You know, there was a time where I struggled with it, but you know, I'm an optimistic person. Bitterness isn't really my natural inclination. Anybody can fall for it, obviously, but
sure.
It was frustrating to be 7 credits shy of a degree and to be
wow.
kicked out. But it was an exciting time. I went to a new college and got to open up all these doors to see, man, you know, you don't have to do these certain things in order to be a good Christian. It's about loving Christ and loving people.
Amen. And having it right in your heart, right?
Yeah.
Talk a little bit about how you wound up on American Idol. So many people enjoyed watching your performance there. How did that come to pass?
I just tried out kind of on a whim. I had a friend who said, this is your last year to try out for American Idol. You know, you're 28 years old. At the time, I was 28, and said, you really should try out. So I went and tried out, and ended up making it all the way to the top 10. It was kind of crazy. I really didn't expect to make it past the first round. I went in and was dressed goofy and, you know, was acting goofy, just telling jokes, and, you know, it ended up making it to the top 10. So it was a pretty incredible experience.
Yeah. Turned down a $250,000 record deal. Boy,
yeah.
How many nights did you have to pray about that?
Well, it was funny. I have my email account has, on the side has these boxes that have like outbox. And I wrote the email to the head of this record label on it, and the email sat in my outbox for about 3.5 weeks. You know, it's like I wrote this whole email and basically said, between me and my God, I feel like I'm supposed to make a record that's more Christian in nature. And I know that that's just not what you guys do. And so I know that you won't understand this. And it just sat in my box for outbox for 3.5 weeks.
For a while,
yeah,
God.
I mean, because that's a lot of money. I mean, I could buy a house, I could buy, you know, there's so many things that you can buy with that much money. And ultimately it just came down to that, you know, I really felt like the choice for me was to make the choice to make a record for the church.
So what's next for you?
You know, I'm touring all over the place. We're getting ready to do, I'm in a unique position as a new artist where even though I haven't proven myself as an artist yet, I'm still at a place where people are interested because of American Idol. And so, you know, we're pretty consistently seeing 300 to 500 people come out and see. We're doing a back to school headlining tour where we're kind of congratulating kids on, you know, and me making fun of the fact that they have to go back to school and I don't. So, you know, it's a great position
to
be in.
Over, isn't it?
Amen.
You're going to sing for us today, but tell us about what the song you're singing means to you.
The song is called Empty Me, and it starts off kind of as my story of American Idol, coming off from the spotlight and coming to a place where I ask God to empty me of myself so I can be filled with Him. And it's a simple prayer that whether or not you're the President of the United States or a dog walker or a cheerleader or some chubby guy that was on American Idol, it's a prayer that all of us can pray as a prayer for our lives.
When people listen to your release, what do you want them to walk away with?
I want them to walk away with truth. You know, whether it's a love song about my wife or it's a song about God's mercies being made new every morning, I want them to come away and understand maybe a little bit more who God is through my lyrics. And that's a lofty goal, obviously. But as I write songs, I just want to convey truth that people are going to walk away and walk away with something more to hold on to than just a catchy tune or, you know, a hook, as they call it in the business.